What's up, everybody? Welcome. In this tutorial, I'm going to talk to you guys about dropping columns. In the previous lecture, we saw how we can drop tables. And in this lecture, I'm going to talk to you about how we can drop columns. For dropping our columns, first of all, I want to create new table. And I want to do this kind of like of remember thing. I will write create and table, and we have to give name to our table. I will just say new underscore table. Okay, after writing this, we need to write open and close parentheses, and in the end we should write our column, semicolon here. Let's click enter and let's write our columns and our data types here. I will say first data type ID and integer. This is data type of this ID, and I will write not null. Okay, after writing not null here, I should write auto and increment. Okay, but not with lower cases. I will write auto underscore increment. Okay, guys, this is my first ID column. I will write comma here and I will click enter. Please guys, you would also create tables like I do, because creating tables using this create statement is not good for you, because you are beginners, and as a beginner it is good to create tables using SQL, because you can get used working with SQL. Let's get started. I will write name and varchar, open and close parentheses, length of this name just 10, and not null, just it is not null. Let's click enter. I will write here, this time I will not write surname, I will just write here salary. Okay, this salary will be integer and will be not null. Okay, and that's it. Let's just click comma and let's click enter. And I will write here, sorry, department. Okay, and this department will be varchar, open and close parentheses, and let's write length of this department. Maybe the department can be long, that is why I should write 20 here. Okay, department can be null. I will say null like this. Okay, and I will click enter. That's it. That is this is my SQL for creating table. And I want to make this ID a primary key. I should write here primary. Okay, primary, and I should write my open and close parentheses here, and I will write here ID. Okay, let's just write like this, primary key and ID. Just remove this gap from here. What is the problem here? Let's see. Oh, here I should write my comma. Okay, guys, this is my true version for creating tables. And I want to show you something. You can remove this primary key from here. I always prefer writing like this, but let me show you another version of this primary key. You can remove this from here. You can come to after this auto increment, you can write primary and key. Okay, this is the same thing as before, and you should remove this indentation, or sorry, it is not indentation, it is comma. You should remove this comma here. Let's just click here. Okay, I will click here and my table is created. Let's click here. You can see my table isn't here. That is why you should right click and you should say refresh all. You can see this new table is already in here. After clicking this new table, you can see here I have columns, ID, name, salary, department, and I have index, foreign case, or etc, etc. But we will work just with this columns. And in this lecture, I will show you dropping columns. For dropping column, we can do this. For example, let's just choose this. For example, let's just, okay, click, right click on this new table. For Dropping this table, you can click here. Where was it? Drop table. Or we said you can come here, you can say drop table, and you can write your table name is new underscore table. You can see like this. But I will not this time use tables. I will just drop column here. Guys, for dropping table, we will use new keyword, and that is called alter. Okay, this alter used for modifying or changing or deleting, inserting or dropping your something into from your SQL, okay, or from your database. And alter is used for this. But for now, you don't need to focus just on this alter. I will talk about this alter in the next section. I will say alter, and let's write table. Okay, you should write your table name. I will say new table and drop, and let's write our column name. But before we writing our column name, I want to click here. I want to show you my columns. You can see ID, name, salary, and department. Let's come here to this drop table. But before we dropping table, let me create new SQL. I will say describe and new underscore table. Okay, let's click on this. You can see this is the columns of my new table. Written here field ID, name, salary, and department. And also you can see from here. Let's come here. Let's say alter table, new table. This is the table of my name, new table, and drop. Let's write column name here. I want to drop this department column name. I will say department. Okay, let's just choose this because in the previous lecture, I showed you how you can run just one SQL into your SQL. Okay, for example, I will just, I will say, I just want to run this, not this. I will just run this. That is why I should choose this. I should click this. Okay, and let's come here. New table. Let's just refresh. Actually, refresh here, not here. Let's click this. Do not save. And I will say refresh all. No, department still here. Because I wrote name here wrong, I should write department. Okay, department. Let's just choose this. Let's click here. And I will come here, new table, and I should refresh this. No, let's come, let's refresh from here. And I will say new table like this. You can see, let's remove this. In here, new table, department of the new table's column is gone. Let's come here, let's remove this. I will say describe and new underscore table. I will click this. You can see here I don't have department because I said here drop this table, and I used here actually three keywords. One of them is alter, one of them table, one of them is drop. Okay, in this lecture we saw two new keywords, and they are alter and drop. I will talk about this alter in the next lecture, but for now you just need to see this drop. But I will cannot explain this drop without writing alter. But you don't know what is alter, I will explain this alter in the next lecture. Okay guys, we came here, we said describe new table, and you can see my column is gone. Let's try to remove all columns here. I will come here, I will choose this, I will click Control and D. Let's just click here enter. I will not say this time just department. Let's remove this. I will say new table, and let's write here salary. Okay, let's choose this again. Let's click this and let's come here. I will choose this. I will run again. You can see salary is gone. Let's drop name. I will remove this. I will say name and let's choose this. Run again. Let's come here, run again. You can see name also is gone. Okay, I will just remove this ID from here. Let's write like this. Let's come here. choose this, and actually ID cannot be gone because ID is the is my last column. That is why we cannot remove this ID. I thought that maybe we have two, but we have just one left column. Okay, that is why you cannot do this. And let's try to do the same operation again. I will remove this. Okay, when I click here again, and when I come here, let's just remove this. Let's refresh all. I will click this indexes. You can see we have just one primary key, and that primary key is, let's remove this, and that primary key is ID. Let's open this columns. You can see we've just one here, and that is ID. Let's create new SQL. I will say drop table, and I will write new underscore table. Let's click this. I will just remove this. Okay, it is gone. Let's come here again. Let's choose this and create. Let's choose this and create run. If I refresh this, you can see my new table is here again. So guys, we saw dropping our columns and dropping our tables again. Let's finish this lesson here. Let's see you in the next tutorial.